Morning, Cheryl. Morning, Monica. Morning, Claire. You're very welcome to the Harry Edwards Virtual Healing Minute. We wait a little longer and relax with the music playing. Music playing today is angelic healing music for mind, body and soul. And I put it from Arjenika Meditation. Morning, Tina. If you're expecting to see Martin today, we've swapped weeks. Martin was doing mine last week and I'm doing his this week. Morning, Jill. Morning, Pauline. Morning, Jane. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today on the Harry Edwards Healing Minute. We are truly grateful for this great community, like-minded people. Can come together, link up, and send wonderful healing angels to all in need. An extra special welcome to any newbies that have joined today. My name is Penny and I'm coming from my home in Surrey on 12th of January 2024. My reading today comes from the Chicken Soul of Soup, the series The Power of Positive. Love yourself for all you are. You were born to be who you are, embrace it. You are a beautiful human. Your unique beauty is yours alone. You have many gifts and talents to share. Share them in your own special way. Your story is yours alone. Use it to help others and theirs. Surround yourself with people who truly see the best of self. Shine your bright light on the world for all to see. You are a miracle. Love yourself for who you are. Attunement and grounding. As we all come together in the Harry Edwards Sanctuary for healing. Attunement and grounding. Close your eyes and just be still. Imagine a column of pure white light entering your entire being. Be in the presence of love. This light has a message for you personally. Imagine the light condescending all limited boundaries that we are currently aware of. Imagine the light connects with individual hearing this and a fortress of light now behind to formulate within you and around you as each one connects to the healing purpose. At the center of your being is a connection to the earth energy. From this point within you, light is anchored to you. Sit and rest for a moment and begin to sense the earth energy, the healing energy from the divinity. You are each a conduit of both energies. Allow them to flow through you. You can fill your entire with these energies just by being. From that space, either by thought, intention, or touch, you're able to illuminate the light with another, and distance is no barrier to these energies. Great invocation. From the point of light that I am, I let light stream forth from the mind of God. Earth radiates with light. From the light of love within the heart of God, I let light stream forth from my heart. I'm a channel radiating earth, energy on earth. From my center where the will of God is known, I let divine purpose guide me, the purpose which all masters know and serve. From the center of the divine human race, I let the plan of love and light work out, and my love sees the door where evil dwells. I am the light and the love and the power, living God's plan on earth. Harry Edwards prayer. May I be thankful for the blessings I already have. Grant me relief from pain and sickness. Protect me from all ills and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me, that I may be conscious of your presence and also receive guidance and inspiration. Grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity. Let me be conscious of your strength in all times of need. Give me confidence to overcome my fears and not to anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to do only that which is right and true. I pray for good guidance and might infinitely will inspire all people to be as brothers, one to the other, and that peace shall endure all times. A prayer for the world. Gracious Father, I pray for the world this coming year. I pray for a peaceful free of war and destruction. I pray that protection for all vulnerable people for this world. Feed the hungry children, save the children in the war-ranged areas. Save us from any pandemic. Protect us from all environment disasters and keep us safe. Rain on our crops and increase the yield. Help us through our lives with protection, love for each other, and let us protect each other and live in peace and harmony. Amen. Sanctuary prayer. Heavenly Father, I surrender myself and the good influences of healing ministers in spirit, that through our divine power, the disharmonies within me might be overcome and the stresses of mind and body be eased and lessened day by day. Help me to adopt a more positive and helpful way of thought, bringing me closer harmony for those around me and with a divine healing purpose. And for those who are sick or in the darkness of despair, do not know that the help reaches them from spirit. I pray that awareness will come to them soon, and they might experience the uplifting spirit that can lead us all through harmony towards true health. May God bless you. And now for all the people's names we hold in the distance healing folders for those across the world that receive healing for the highest good. We also request healing for our families, friends, animals and people for whom I requested distant healing. We now call in Harry Edwards and his healing team and our healing teams in your intention to let them be placed in the healing light and receive that which they are allowed to receive for the highest good. We'll have 1 minute of silence for the healing minutes. Thank you and blessings for your help here today, all our friends in spirit. Thank you everyone, that was so powerful. Thank you for sending your healing out. The events for January. Yoga is now on Thursday and be held in the Brazier Room 12:30 to 1:30. On Sunday the 14th of January, Alan Healing for You will be at 7:30. Join him on Zoom. The Terrace Cafe is now open from 9:30 to 3 p.m. and Thursday to Sunday. On the 18th of January, join John for meditation in the sanctuary from 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock. The Bereavement Cafe will also be on the 18th of January, 11 to 1 o'clock. On the 25th of January, John will be holding his meditation online from 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock. And Jean will be holding the healing service on the 28th of January on Sunday. Please note the new time, 11 to 12. Don't forget to check the events and the Facebook to keep an eye on all the events that are coming up in the future. Thank you. Now my story today is taken from the Chicken Soup of Souls, from the Power of Positive series. Now I tried several times thinking, well, this isn't the right story, but each time the story came up. So here it is. The day I took control, to my surprise, I tugged the jeans over my hips. I yanked the zip, the effect leaving me practically breathless. Then I stood back and looked at my reflection in the dressing room mirror. Flash spilled over my waistband. I checked the tag. The jeans were the usual size. Probably just in proper cut, I reassured myself. Yet when the zipper on the next pair of jeans I selected wouldn't budge, I had to step back and admit the cold hard truth to myself. My weight was once again out of control. My struggle with my weight started long before, as my mother would say when I was young. She first introduced me to cookies and milk. Who would pass that up? Cookies and milk. I mean, who would pass something up like that? A warm chocolate chip cookie straight from the oven, washed down with a glass of milk. What about an oatmeal cookie filled with plump sweet raisins? And don't even get me started on brownies, plain frosted, or the kind I recently discovered behind the glass case in the specialised market with soft peanut butter filling. I couldn't resist such goodies, though I tried many, many times. Through a combination of various diets and sheer willpower, I diet myself down to the acceptable weight a number of times through the years. Liquid, high, protein, low, calories, counting, and points and systems diets. I've done them all. In fact, I was practically a weight loss expert. What I wasn't, however, was a maintenance expert. After reaching my goal, the weight would eventually return. When I found my heart pounding as I climbed the stairs, I felt an ache in my knees. I was unable to peel up a zipper or revisit my cycle of diet and weight loss followed by overeating, weight gain. I know this was a dangerous circle. Yet while I had all the skills I needed to lose the weight, I lacked those I needed to maintain the loss. Invariably, it seemed always backslide to the effort, lured by my sweet love of sweets. There in the fitting room, my flabby reflection stared back at me, disgusted. I huffed and puffed as I pulled off the jeans and put my own clothes on. I assessed that I saw above the double chin, dull hair, pallid complexion, circles under my eyes, all telltale sign of poor health. I looked bad. But worst of all, I felt bad inside and out. I lacked drive, and frequently I passed on social invitations because I didn't have the energy or the exercise. Forget about that. There was no cookies worth this, I thought, as I placed the off-cast clothes on the return rack. That afternoon, I went back home determined and finally cleared my cabinets and myself of all unnecessary excess. However, I'd be lying to say the next step wasn't easy. Tossing out each poor but tasty favorite food was like letting go of an old friend. As I dropped each item in the garbage, I followed the suggestion of an article I had read in a woman's magazine and created a helpful mantra. With each piece of junk food I threw out, I chanted, "You don't rule me anymore. You don't rule me anymore. Chocolate, you don't rule me anymore. Cookies, you don't rule me anymore. Cakes, you don't rule me anymore." Though half-heartedly, at first my mantra eventually took root in the deepest part of me. But by the end of the exercise, I discovered tossing out all the unhealthy foods helped me to reclaim the upper hand in the quest of a healthy living. The next step of my journey was further exercise on my newfound authority over my body. By finding a sensible lifestyle program, I started visiting bookshops and thumbling through some weight loss books. Soon I found myself, I felt I could live with no more being a slave, counting, measuring or fasting. Just a good healthy eating partnered with regular program. With that selected, I went to the grocery store to collect the supply I needed to see my new life through, lifestyle through. I began the produce area, sneaked my way through the store with each good choice I made. I felt even more empowered. Then rounded the corner towards the bakery aisle. There stood, surrounded with my old friends, all manner of cookies, cakes, buns and muffins. I glanced into the cart filled with low fat, low calcium and whole grain provisions. I took a deep breath and struggled to repeat my mantra, "You don't rule me anymore, you don't rule me anymore." Then I picked up a white bakery box, looking lovely through the clear plastic window. Inside, cakes piled high with sugary, buttery cinnamon crumbs winked at me. I swear I could actually hear it speak. "Take me home," it said. "Just a little there and there won't hurt you." I held the box for seemed a long time, finally scrunching up my eyes and shaking my head to break the spell. "You don't rule me anymore," I said loud. "I rule me." I placed the back box down so hard it made it to the surprise of the supermarket employee and other shoppers nearby. "Really, honey," one grandmotherly woman joked in my direction. "You shouldn't be so hard, it's only a crumble cake." But she was so wrong. I realised I did have to be hard on the poor choices I had allowed to control me all the way. That day, the magnet pull that sweet had over me for most of my life ended once and for all. Thank you for my newfound regime of healthy food choices and a moderate exercise. I'm able to report that I have since reached my weight goal and maintained that weight for over 10 years. I am more active in my middle years than I was as a teen. I now look myself, no puffing and puffing, every day. More important though, each year at my annual doctor's physical, they confirm that I am remained tip-top shape. I still hear the siren of the song of cookies and cakes and candies. Sometimes I indulge in a little, yet I feel the urge to take a larger piece for second goes. I remind myself that I hold the power within the health that concerns, and repeat the mantra again and again that set the straight about the sugar foods that I once held swayed over me. You don't rule me anymore. You don't rule me anymore. And now I rule me. By Monica Anderman. Now I've got a couple of light-hearted poems. Half a pound is wonderful. Half a pound is great. Imagine half a pound of lard sitting on your plate. Although those halves, they soon add up and you get where you want to be. So don't be sad. Don't be blue. Instead, well done me. Sometimes our journey takes us longer than we thought, but still we get there in the end, although at times we are fraught. So pat yourself on your back and please don't be glum. If you lose another half a pound, remember it adds up to one, and another, and another. And one more, the Monday diet. Today I'll start once. Today is Monday, I'll start once more. With my diet like a thousand times before, this time I'll make it, I know I can. Because Sunday I ate all I could chew. Monday started so good. For breakfast I had one fruit. Later for lunch I went to the store to buy some lettuce, tomatoes, cabbage and more. And then my tummy started to scream when I saw the coconut, the chocolate donuts, the cakes, the sweets. And there I am, back where I am. Sorry. Okay. My choice today is Joss Gobham. Oh my words today. Joss Gobham. Good Gobham. Singing The Impossible Dream. Sorry about my words today.
To follow the sky.
Do remember, if you want healing, just need a chat, we're here for you. Whether you're on Sanctuary on contact healing, or you wish to have telephone or Zoom healing, just contact us in the normal way to arrange appointments. All details are on the website or Facebook. And don't forget to check on the website and the Facebook for the events to come. Lovely Bev will be with you tomorrow. Lovely Tara on Sunday. And lovely Tracy on Monday. I shall remember that motto. What I've just been reading about weight loss. And there's an affirmations. Also a little step I take leads to big chances. Changes. I let go of old habits that no longer serve me. I am in control of my eating habits. I am losing weight with every possible decision I make. And remember our motto states, wherever you are, we're here for you. A big thank you for joining us today on Live on Catch Up. And may your light always shine through the days ahead. Bye for now, and please take care, and thank you for staying with me. I'll see you again next week. Bless you all, and thank you, everyone. Bless you.